Can you believe another year has already come and gone? I certainly can't. Feels like it was only yesterday when I was putting away all the Pokemon Plush for 2021. But here we are in 2022, and we have new Pokemon games. Pokemon Legends Arceus, Pokemon Scarlet, and Pokemon Violet.
And with them have come a legion of new Pokemon, as well as controversies, glitches, bugs, and the likes.
You know, you come to expect a lot more from the second highest grossing media franchise on the planet, second only to Winnie the Pooh.
But hey, let's look at the positive side of things, shall we?
Regardless on your thoughts on the games, the cards, the anime, or the likes, one thing's gonna be for certain. Pokemon isn't going anywhere anytime soon. Which also means there's going to be lots of new Pokemon to collect.
Alright, that's enough stalling. Time to showcase the new Pokemon plush that I obtained in 2022.
Let us begin with where it all started. The Kanto region, or Generation 1. And I know I gave these games a lot of flack in the past, how they're full of glitches and bugs and the likes, and yes, they are. But at the same time, we also got games like Pokemon Stadium and Pokemon Snap, so it wasn't all that bad. And here are the new plush. Starting with the Sitting Cuties line, we have Metapod. Here is Weedle. Here is Kakuna. Here we have another Machoke. Here we have Nidorino. And lastly, from the Sitting Cuties line, we have Execute. A fan actually said that we did not have Execute in the last video, so here he is. Sorry we missed him. Here's a Machamp. This is from the Pokemon Center. It is a posable plush, in the same vein as Gallade or Scizor, if you've seen my previous videos. Jack-specific Psyduck. The other one, I'm not too sure if he's official or not, because there are a few bootlegs for Jack-specific plush, but this one is 100% genuine. A Tomy Growlithe. A Tomy Wait, what? Tomy? Are you sure this is the same company? I mean, that Growlithe plush looked kind of meh. Yeah, it is. Same company, because over the years, Tomy actually got really good with the plushes over here in America, and this Ninetales is perfect. Absolutely perfect. Another Growlithe was released by Wicked Cool Toys, as you can see here. And when comparing the two, the Wicked Cool Toys one wins, no question. Look at the proportions on the face. This one looks really compressed, whereas the Wicked Cool Toys one actually looks, well, proportionate. Also, the Wicked Cool Toys Growlithe is much, much larger than the Tomy one. And last but not least, we have a Dratini plush by Jazzwares. And it's about time I got one. I mean, there's been one from the Pokemon Center, there's been one with the Dragonite plush, there's been a KFC plush, but hey, I like this one. And so, here is my updated Generation 1, or Kanto, Pokemon plush collection. Now, I know I've talked about the games in the past, but I haven't really discussed the anime all that much, and to be honest, with Generation 1, I feel like the writing was actually pretty good at times, pretty dry and witty, but the stories were pretty bare bones and pretty similar to one another. Like, literally, episode after episode after episode, they were very repetitive, but I feel like the writers were kind of aware of it, and that's why they made the characters, especially Team Rocket, really likable and enjoyable to watch. Next is Generation 2, or Johto. Like I said in the past, this generation only has 100 Pokemon total, so it makes collecting them a little easier, and I'm actually pretty close to completion, if you don't count all the unknown, which I do not plan on collecting. Like, I'm crazy enough to catch all the Unova Pokemon, but all the unknown? Woof! No way! And now for the new plush. Let's get these guys out of the way first. Another Wooper by Jack Specific, and another Sneasel by Jack Specific. These two I managed to pick up at a swap meet. The rest are all by Sitting Cuties, starting with Ledian. Next is Slugma. I had Macargo, but noticed I didn't have Slugma for some reason, so here we are. In the same vein, we have Hoppip, but we don't have Skiploom or Jumpluff. Now, I know the Jay Witz absolutely loves Hoppip, but not sure what his thoughts are on the other two. Speaking of Jumpluff, here we are, with these big, fluffy cotton balls on the plush. Here is Remoraid. Not sure what to think of Remoraid. Probably the most weird evolution out there. Like, you have a Remora that evolves into an octopus. Like, of all evolutions, like, Okay, sure. And finally, for Generation 2, here is Smoochum, one of the baby Pokemon this generation, like Tyrogue, Magby, or Elekid. So, here's my current Johto, or Generation 2, Pokemon Plush collection. Again, since there's only 100 Pokemon, it's not very big, but there's still a few notable Pokemon that are missing. Miltank, Spinarak, Hoot Hoot, Ladybug, they're all missing, and so are the legendary beasts. So hopefully next year I'll be able to obtain them, but we'll see. Next is Generation 3, or Hoenn, which, although not my favorite generation, is definitely up there. It also is home to one of my favorite Pokemon games, that being Pokemon XD Gale of Darkness. A lot of great Pokemon in this generation, but ever notice that there's only two evolutions and they're both baby Pokemon, those being Why Not and Azurill? Okay, sure, okay. There's only four new plush, starting with Volbeat from the Sitting Cuties line. And here is Illumise. You can't have one without the other, can you? Here is a Chimecho from my Pokemon collection, Bam Presto plush. And here is a less deformed, better looking Salamence from the Pokemon All-Star collection. So, here's my updated Generation 3, or Hoenn, Pokemon Plush Collection. Now, granted, it's not as big as it was last year, I get that, but the reason for that's because we kinda almost caught them all, to be honest. There are a few Pokemon that were missing, like the aforementioned Azurill and Why Not, and there's Marshtomp, Groval, and Combusken. I know Makuhita is also on the list, but other than them, I think most of the plush are here and accounted for. I mean, I'm sure I'm probably missing one or two. I know I'm missing one or two. And if I am, please let me know in the comments, because like with the Execute situation, if I'm missing a plush, chances are I'll be able to snatch it, and I'll be one step closer to completing the decks. And so if you do, big thanks! And here we have Sinnoh, or Generation 4. Now, these games are infamous for having their long, slow HP bars that drain like nobody's business, the text boxes that move oh so slowly, and the region of fantastic Pokemon. With a few exceptions, of course. Exceptions that I don't want to talk about. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. For the most part, this region is fantastic. The villains are kind of meh. The gym leaders are good, the music's good, the champion is probably the best one we've had. I mean, Leon's also great, don't get me wrong, but Cynthia is always going to be one of the best. As for the new plush, there's only three, starting with Hippopotas from the Sitting Cuties line, a Pokemon that I missed last time around that I didn't miss this time. Here is Hippopotas' evolution, Hippowdon. What would have been interesting is if we actually got a male and female variant of the Hippowdon, because there is no female variant, there's only males. And from the Pokemon Sanae All-Star Collection, we have Gible. As you can see here, he is much better and bigger in detail than the old Banpresto My Pokemon Collection Gible. I mean, that one, don't get me wrong, looks good, but this one just has more detail. Gible! Here you go, right in front of the Unmentionables, there you go. So here is my updated Generation 4, or Sinnoh, Pokemon Plush Collection. As you can see, there aren't really many new plush this time around, but that's because we already managed to obtain a grand chunk of them, just like Generation 3. Dare I say, there's not very many left to collect, and again, I know there's probably a few Pokemon that I missed. Again, I'm not too sure which ones though, so please leave them in the comments, and I'll be able to find them, and I'll be able to catch them for myself. And here we are, Unova, or Generation 5. My favorite Pokemon generation, and I'm sure if you've been on my channel for a long time or seen any of the previous plush collections, you'll know that I like Unova quite a bit. I've said it once and I'll say it a million times over, this was the first generation to give every single Pokemon a plush, no matter how obscure they may be. So that means no matter how obscure the Pokemon was, be it Golurk, Vanillish, Mianfoo, Electros, or Simisage, they all got plush. Every last Pokemon got a plush from this generation. It's actually kind of impressive. Actually, for Generation 5, the only new Pokemon we got were Scraggies and Scrafties. Starting with this Banpresto Scraggy, as you can see here. Banpresto My Pokemon Collection Scraggy. And finally, three, count them, three, Scrafties. Now, why am I collecting so many Scrafties? Well, if you're a veteran to the channel, you'll probably know, but for any newcomers, welcome. But it's because I have a little show called Pokemon All-Starters, and a lot of these Pokemon, including the Scrafties, make some pretty good villainous team grunts. So here is my somewhat updated Generation 5, or Unova, Pokemon Plush Collection. Now, again, the thing is, the reason why we just got a bunch of Scraggies and Scrafties is because, We're complete with this one. We're complete with this collection. Every single Pokemon is here, and of the time of uploading this video, the Sitting Cutie slash Pokemon Fit line for these guys has not come out yet, and thank goodness. Why? Because we already have everybody. Like, oh my goodness. That would be, like, double the amount of Pokemon here. I mean, don't get me wrong. I would really like to have Pokemon Fit plush of all of these other Pokemon. But at the same time, we already have everybody, so I'm just probably not going to buy them when they come around. Next we have Kalos, or Generation 6, which contains the fewest number of Pokemon, unless you count Legends Arceus, which I don't. We actually have three new Pokemon this region, starting off with Quilladin from the Pokemon Center, Abampresto, my Pokemon Collection Spritzy, and the most interesting choice, a Sane Pokemon All-Star Collection Sliggoo. Like, okay, Sliggoo is an interesting choice. I'm glad Sliggoo has a plush. Like, of all the Pokemon you could have picked, you picked Sliggoo? Thank you. I also really like how he has beans on his bottom. Like, I don't know, I just really like that feature as he slithers around. So here's my updated Generation 6 or Kalos Pokemon plush collection. Now, why do I not like Gen 6? The games are too easy. I'm sorry, the games are just really, really easy, and I really, really don't like that about Pokemon. I love the grinding, I actually really liked how it felt like your own personal accomplishment, rather than having the EXP share on for the whole time, and also the villains kinda sucked. Alola! Welcome to Generation 7. I'm just realizing, when they say Alola, that not only means hello and goodbye, but it also refers to the region. Like, anyone else ever realize that? Like, when you say Alola, are you talking about the region, or are you saying hello, goodbye? Like, for this region, we only have one new plush, but whew, is it a good one? The one, the only, Serena. This is the Sane All-Star Collection Serena. She looks absolutely fantastic, and was one of the plush I was really hoping they would make. They made Bounsweet, they made Steenie, but they never made Serena, and, well, here we are. So here's my updated Generation 7 or Alolan Pokemon plush collection. Again, I'm still mind-boggled by this. How come Alola not only represents the name of the region, but also means hello and goodbye as well? Like, Hawaii is called Hawaii. You don't say Aloha as the name of the state. It's called the Aloha State. Like, I get that, but at the same time, why the heck would you name the place? Right, I'm sorry. I went on a tangent. Speaking of Cramorant, here is Galar or Generation 8. Hey. Remember when we all said that Generation 8 had a ton of problems? Remember when we said that the graphics didn't look great? Remember when we said that the artists are putting their time and effort into the making of this game? They still are. But do you miss Sword and Shield? Because I know I do. I miss Sword and Shield a lot. For all it was, it still had a lot of great stuff in it. And Wooloo was one of them. We do have a few new plush for the region, starting with Rookidee, a pure flying type. Impressive. Now Tornadus doesn't have to be alone. We got both variants of Ice Cube, starting with the Ice Face Ice Cube and the
Nice
Face Ice Cube. And lastly, we have Greedent, a big squirrel Pokemon that I happen to like. I like its derpy looking design. Reminds me a lot of Beedrill. It's also very, very greedy. So here is my current Generation 8 or Galarian Pokemon plush collection. I feel like we gave Gen 8 a little too much hate in my opinion. Sure, I get it, the whole national deck situation, yeah, but at the same time, the artists shouldn't have been ridiculed, neither should have the musicians. They all did a fantastic job with the game, and all things considered, the designers did a great job. So, overhated? In my opinion, yes. There haven't been a whole lot of new Pokemon in this video, have there? I mean, here's Red, but all the other trainers mysteriously vanished. And in their place was this substitute. Oh god, evil teddy bear! Fortunately, Legends Arceus brought us a few new Pokemon. Let's have a look, shall we? This is Generation 8.5, as I like to call it, or the Hisuian region. Starting off, we have Hisuian Decidueye, who was a grass fighting type back in the day, with kicks that could rival that of Chun-Li. Here is Hisuian Typhlosion with his very derpy face. A fire ghost type, and here is Hisuian Samurott, who was a water dark type. Thank you for acknowledging Generation 5, because compared to Gen 1, it doesn't get a whole lot of love. Speaking of Gen 1, here is Hisuian Voltorb. What confuses me is how come he looks like a Pokeball even though Pokeballs didn't exist back in the day? I thought Voltorb was supposed to be like a ghost trapped in a Pokeball, or was it a Pokeball that went defective? I mean, it's really confusing. I don't know what to make of you, Voltorb. You're just pfft. Here's Hisuian Zorua. And here's Hisuian Zoroark, looking like a very, very, very edgy OC. Here Here is Basculegion. Well, granted, you can't evolve regular Basculin into Basculegion, and the process in getting this Pokemon's a pain in the rear, at least they gave Basculin something, which I am very appreciative of. And here is Cleaver. Please go back. We miss Scizor. Please go back. Please, please go back. Nothing wrong with Cleaver, it's just... I miss Scizor. So, here is the Generation 8.5, or Hisuian, Pokemon Plush Collection. And, since Scarlet and Violet just came out, here are the starters from the Paldea region, or Generation 9. Whew, can't believe we're at Gen 9 already. Those being Sprigatito, Quaxley, and Fuecoco. Hey!
Heavens, they're multiplying.
And last but definitely not least, we have the mythical and legendary Pokemon. We have two new mythical Pokemon, starting with Genesect. This was released for Pokemon's 20th anniversary. Unfortunately, I forgot the brand name. I'll put it on screen right now. And from Pokemon Center, here is Diancie. And compared to the other Diancie, this is a much needed improvement. And here are the legendary Pokemon. You can't have a generation without a few of these guys. And I know Koridon and Maridon just released, as well as Zacian and Zamazenta a few years ago, but I do not have them in my collection yet. Hopefully we'll get them next year. Also down here are the Ultra Beasts. Not legendaries, but I like to consider them in the same ballpark. And the same thing applies with Rotom. Not because he's a legendary, but in Generation 4 they wanted him to be so badly. And so, I felt like including him here. He's too original to be with the others. We have five new legendaries, starting with the Pokemon Dolls Pokemon Center plush, Regieleki. Hello, fast new Pokemon. From the same line, here is Regidrago. And that is one big family. Next is, who is this? My notes say that her name is Enamorous and she's from the Hisuian region, same ballpark as- Oh my god, she's supposed to be related to the Weather Trio! A lot of people really don't like her design, and, I don't know what to say about her. What do you think, boys?
No!
Exactly. Here is White Kyurem by Takara Tomy. And last but definitely not least, we have Pokemon Center Kyurem. Absolute majesty of a plush. This guy is a beast. And now he's the same size as Zekrom and Reshiram. And so, the Pokemon Plush Collection update comes to a close for another year. Now, a question I constantly get, especially this year alone, is what do you think of the new Pokemon games, Scarlet and Violet? My thoughts? Kind of a mixed bag. On the one hand, I think the new Pokemon are absolutely fantastic. I absolutely love a lot of their designs. We finally got a dolphin Pokemon, we finally got a flamingo, we finally got a peacock, kind of. But at the same time, the game is filled to the brim with glitches and bugs. A lot of them were found very, very early on. You could tell these games had very limited production time. In Generation 1, this was somewhat excusable, considering the fact that the games were fresh out the gate for the Game Boy. But the year is 2022, and these games are for the Switch. It just boggles my mind how one of the highest grossing media franchises on the planet could care so little about its games. Let alone these games released in 2022. The thing is, no matter how glitchy the games are, they will be bought. The new Pokemon, the new region, the new music, everything. So while I don't hate Scarlet and Violet, at the same time, I just wish there was a little more development time put into the games. Maybe then they could have been as good as Black and White too. Think of Scarlet and Violet like a pie. Now obviously you want that pie when it's nice and fully baked, right? Well, Scarlet and Violet to me feel like a pie that just got taken out of the oven a little too early. Sure, it still tastes pretty good, but at the same time it's very doughy and it doesn't taste complete. It's not exactly completed and it doesn't have that full punch. It's doughy, you can tell it's doughy and that it's incomplete, but you still like it anyway. At this point, the Pokemon games, especially Scarlet and Violet, and especially Legends Arceus, are just like that pie. Sure, they taste great, but at the same time it's not complete. You still endure with the doughy parts of the pie, and that's the problem. Why go for an incomplete pie when you can go for the completed product? And since these games are made by such a limited staff, I feel like, again, if they hired more staff or if they had a longer development time, then maybe, just maybe, these games could return back to their original fantastic state. And I'm sorry for my rant. It's just Pokemon's a franchise that I hold near and dear to my heart, and I just don't want to see it going down the path it's going right now. It really hurts me to see, and I know it hurts a lot of fans, too. And again, I never said these games were bad. The Pokemon look fantastic, the music's great, but regardless, at this rate, I feel like the games just need a nice step in the right direction. If they're able to do that, then chances are they can hit a grand slam out of the park again, like they did with Ruby and Sapphire, Diamond and Pearl, and Black and White. Yes, I know, I'm sorry, I'll stop. Other questions I get are, where do you get the plush? The answers are Pokemon Center for the Sitting Cuties line, or Pokemon Center plush like Inteleon. There's also eBay, Amazon, although Amazon's kind of untrustworthy. There's also Mercari, and various Japanese auction sites if you want your plush from Japan. Another question I got is, what was your first Pokemon game? Now, because I talk about XD a lot, you think I'd bring up Pokemon XD, but no. My first game was actually Pokemon Stadium. I remember using the rental Pokemon all the time back in Pokemon Stadium, and then using Zapdos, spamming Thunder on every Pokemon I could, and then losing to Pokemon like Golem because they're ground types. Another question I have is, what kind of Pokemon would you want to see as a plush? To that, I already have an answer. Kamoho. He's the only Pokemon that's a pseudo-legendary to not have a plush. And to that, I ask, why? Well, I've run out of stuff to say, so until they make Pokemon Legends Zygarde or something like that, or whatever they do in 2023, this is Luigi Fan Quada 1 signing out, saying see you guys later, and have yourselves a fantastic day. Well, that video went pretty good. Alright, time to get some food.
Blech. Ugh, I can't believe he ate us like that! Squawk! Is that why we weren't in the collection? Right, so. Squawk!
Shh! He's coming back! He's coming back!
Blech. Bang!
Aww. We have a problem.